Hello friends, we have already started this point, microbiological examination of water. And in last lecture, we have studied about the different methods. The first was multiple tube fermentation test, and then second we have studied that is about the elevated temperature test. Today we will study about the third method, which is used for the microbiological examination of water, and the name of that test is, or technique is, membrane filtration technique. This membrane filtration technique, it is a very useful technique in microbiological examination of water, as well as it is used for different purposes in microbiology. So today we will see about this third technique or third test, that is membrane filtration technique. So under this heading we will see the first point, what is meant by this membrane filtration technique. Then we will see what is this membrane filter. We will just see some introductory part about this membrane filter. Then we will see that is absorbent pad. We will see about this absorbent pad and what is its use. Absorbent pad and use. Then we will see about the membrane filtration assembly. So which are the different components of that membrane filtration assembly, that we will see, and the heading is here membrane filtration assembly. Membrane filtration assembly. Then next we will see that is about, next point is here, method of membrane filtration, or we will see that is the procedure of this membrane filtration technique. Okay, membrane filtration technique. Now the next point we will see about the advantages and disadvantages of this membrane filtration technique. Okay, advantages and disadvantages of this membrane filtration technique. So today we are going to cover these different points or subtopics in this membrane filtration technique, and that includes what is meant by membrane filtration technique. Then we will see about the membrane filter. Then we will see absorbent pad. Next we will see membrane filtration assembly. Then procedure for this membrane filtration technique. And lastly, we will see about the advantages and disadvantages of this membrane filtration technique. Now let's start the first point, that is what is meant by this membrane filtration technique. So I will erase this so that, now before starting, students, if you have not subscribed this Microbiology by Santosh Napte, so kindly subscribe it. If you like these videos, just click on that like button If you are not liking these videos, click on that unlike button or dislike button, comment on and share with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe this Microbiology by Santosh Napte, so you will get notifications of this upcoming video. So let's start with first point. So the first point is here, what is meant by this membrane filtration technique? This membrane filtration technique, it is also called as millipore filter technique. It is also known as millipore filter technique. Filter technique. Okay. So here, now we know that this membrane filtration technique, it is useful for microbiological examination of water or microbiological analysis of water. So this is the most useful fit technique for the checking of quality of water. So it is useful for the microbiological examination of water or analysis of water. Now this technique, in this technique there is a use of a special filter. There is a use of special filter, and like, or it is a membrane filter. It is called as membrane filter. So here, as I told earlier, here this method is very effective method. This is the very effective method for the isolation of bacteria from the water sample, so that we can determine the quality of that particular water. So here, so this membrane filtration method, it was introduced in the late 1950s. When it was introduced, so this membrane filtration technique, it was introduced in late 1950, and the main purpose of this technique is, so the main purpose of this technique is to determine the presence of, so what is the purpose of this test here? So the main purpose of this technique is to determine the presence or absence of, presence or absence of coliform microorganisms. Coliform microorganisms in the, or during the testing of water. If you want to determine the quality of water, then you can use this membrane filtration technique, and by using this technique we can determine whether that water sample consists of that coliform bacteria or not. So we can determine the presence or absence of these coliform bacteria in that water sample. So that is the main purpose of this technique here. And now, so this is about the general introduction about this membrane filtration technique, and by studying this, now we know this is useful or used for checking of quality of water, whether it is potable or unpotable for drinking purpose, that can be checked, and later on it can detect the presence or absence of it can det- this test is useful to detect the presence or absence of coliform bacteria in that water sample. So this is about this introductory part. Now the next we will see. Now the next point we will see, that is, what is this membrane filter? So this membrane filter, it is a molecular or biological filter. Made from cellulose. It is made from cellulose esters. So this membrane filter, it is biological or molecular filter, and it is made from cellulose esters which have the uniform or predetermined pore size. So this membrane filter, it has the uniform pore size, and this uniform pore size, it is actually responsible for the trapping of microorganisms which are present in that water. So this pore size of this membrane filter, it ranges from, or the microorganisms which are trapped in this membrane filter, that is cellulose filters, it ranges from 0.01 micrometer to 0.10 micrometer to 0.10 micrometer. So these are the size of microorganisms which are trapped in this membrane filtration technique, that in that membrane filter. So because of trapping of this microorganisms on this membrane filter, which later on transfer to specific nutrient medium, and that presence or absence of that coliform bacteria can be detected. See here, I will show you a simple diagram of this membrane filter. So this is the membrane filter here, and on this membrane filter, suppose there are, now this membrane filter, it has the very small pore size. That small pores, it traps that microorganisms which are present in that water or in that water sample here. So this is about the membrane filter, for example, and this membrane filter, it has the very small pores like this. There is a inter or crossing is there, that, and because of this crossing, there is a very small pores of this, or which trap that bacteria, and only that water sample can be transferred here. But the bacteria which are microorganisms which are having larger size than the pores, these microorganisms are trapped on this membrane filter here. So these are the, so this is the membrane filter, these are the, that pores here on which or through which that water get transferred here or get filtered, but the microorganisms which are larger than this pore size, these microorganisms get trapped here, and that's why they remain on this membrane filter. So here, now there is a adding of water sample which is to be tested. So there is a test sample, you can see here, it is added, and later on, so whatever that microorganisms are present here in that water sample, these microorganisms, they get trapped here. For example, these are the microorganisms which are present in that water sample, and these microorganisms, they get trapped here. So these microorganisms, or the these microorganisms, they get trapped on this membrane filter, and later on, so whatever that now filtrate will be here, that filtrate, It is completely free of microorganisms. It is completely free of microorganisms, and we can say it as a filtrate. Okay. So here, but these microorganisms which are present in that water sample or test sample, these microorganisms get trapped on this membrane filter. So this is called as membrane filter, which has the pore size of that 0.01 micrometer to 0.10 micrometer. So these size of microorganisms, they get trapped here, and so this is called as the membrane filter. Now the next point is here, that is about adsorbent pad, or it is known as absorbent pad. The next point is, that is absorbent pad. Now this absorbent pad, it consists of filter paper disc. Now the second portion is here, that is absorbent pad. So this absorbent pad, it consists of filter paper disc, and which actually suppresses the growth of microorganisms here. It consists of filter paper discs, which are free of sulfides and other compounds. Free of these filter paper discs, these are free of sulfides and other compounds, and this suppresses the growth of bacteria here. This membrane filtration technique, now whatever these absorbent pads are here, these absorbent pads which are made up of filter paper disc, they have the diameter of, so this absorbent pad, they have, just I will take the new page here. See, this absorbent pad which are made up of filter paper disc, they have the diameter of, so the diameter of this, just 1 minute, these absorbent pad, they have the diameter of 48 millimeter. So the diameter of this absorbent pad is 48 millimeter, and thickness is 0.8 millimeter. So this is the dimensions of this absorbent pad, and the absorbent paper, it absorbs near about, or this absorbent paper or disc, it absorbs near about 1.8 to 2.2 ml of this water sample, or any sample of this water sample or test sample here, we can see. So this is about the absorbent pad. Now next point we are going to study here, that is the actual part of this membrane filtration technique, and which is called as membrane filtration assembly. So just 1 minute, I will rub all these things here, so we will get a space for writing. In next point we are going to study about that membrane filtration assembly, because this membrane filtration assembly, it has the different components which are very useful for the membrane filtration technique, or that becomes the very important part of that membrane filtration technique. So here next point we will see, that is about the membrane filtration assembly. So that is about the membrane filtration assembly. So here we will see membrane filtration assembly, or we can say membrane filtration unit. Okay, so this membrane filtration assembly or membrane filtration unit, it consists of different parts. So here this, they comprises, or this membrane filtration assembly, It consists of different components here, and that components are the funnel. It consists of funnel for the addition of that water sample. Then later on, it consists of locking ring. This is also the important part of membrane filtration assembly. Then it consists of this carbon disc. Then this, there is a another part, that is stainless steel base or stainless base. Stainless base. The next one is here, rubber stopper. Fifth part is rubber stopper. The next portion of this membrane filtration assembly is filter flask, and the last one is here, that is, there is a presence of, or it consists of, vacuum pump. So it is useful for the sucking or suction pump, we can see here, for the sucking of that water sample which is added in the funnel, so it get fastly filtered. So this is about the different components of the membrane filtration assembly here. So in diagram, now how this membrane filtration assembly looks, so that's we will see here how this membrane filtration assembly looks. Now if you see the diagram of this membrane filtration assembly, now we know the different components of that membrane filtration assembly. So this is the that funnel here. So this is the funnel, or which is the important part of that membrane filtration assembly. This is called as funnel here. So this is known as funnel of this membrane filtration assembly, and from here there is a water is added which is to be tested. So this is funnel. Then later on, this is, now it is called as locking ring. So this is known as the locking ring, which is also the important part of this membrane filtration assembly. Then later on, there is a, that membrane filter is actually, this is called as the membrane filter here, which is the having special pore size, and which is responsible for the trapping of that microorganism which are present in the water sample. So this is called as the membrane filter. So this is membrane filter. And next portion is here, that is the stainless base. So this is called as stainless base of this membrane filtration assembly. And then later on, there is a rubber stopper is here. So this is the portion of this stainless base. And then this is called as rubber stopper. And finally here, this is the filter flask. So this is called as filter flask. So these are the different components of the membrane filtration assembly. And from the another side, there is a vacuum pump is here. So this is called as vacuum pump. So these are the different components of the membrane filtration assembly or unit. Okay. So this is about the membrane filtration assembly. Now, next point we will see how this membrane filtration assembly is used for the checking of water quality. So how this membrane filtration assembly used, or how that water can be filtered through this membrane filtration assembly, that we will see under the procedure or the method of membrane filtration. Now the next point we will see, that is method for membrane filtration, or these steps, or simply we can see here the procedure for membrane filtration technique. Okay, so the first steps involves the collection of sample. So the water sample which is to be tested, that water sample is collected. That's why it is the first step here, collection of water sample. Then second one is selection of appropriate nutrient medium, because there is a different water samples are there, so that's why it involves the selection of proper or appropriate nutrient medium. Appropriate nutrient medium. Next steps involves the membrane filtration. The next steps involves filtration of that water sample, or that is called as membrane filtration, or filtering of that water sample through that membrane filter. So that is the next step here. Next step involves placing of membrane filter. Placing of membrane filter, because it is a very important part of this process here. So that's why it is important step. Next step of this membrane filtration technique is, that is fifth steps, it involves incubation. Once we have placed that membrane filter and after filtration of that water sample, the next step is incubation. The next one is quantitative analysis, because this membrane filtration technique, it can be useful to check the water quality quantitatively as well as qualitatively. So the next one is here, quantitative analysis, and the last one is here, that is qualitative analysis. So we can do here quantitative as well as qualitative analysis of that water sample. So these are the different steps involved in the procedure of this membrane filtration technique here. So the first one we will see, that is collection of water sample. So the first step is here, collection of water sample, and that water samples, that may be groundwater or any water sample that is collected by a proper method, and that is taken in a sterilized bottles. So that sterile bottles are used for the collection of this water sample from different sources here. So it is very essential to use these sterile bottles for the collection of this water sample here. Then next one is here, that is selection of appropriate nutrient medium. So the medium which is useful for this membrane filtration techniques, now that depends on the type of microorganisms which you are going to identify. Suppose if you are identifying that TC, or we can call it as a total coliforms, then the medium which is useful, it is endo agar, or the another medium is here, that is called as EMB, or that is eosin methylene blue agar. If you are identifying or isolating that fecal coliforms or FC, then there is a use of MFC medium. Okay, that is the coliform medium here. Then if you are identifying or isolating that yeast from that water sample, yeast and mold, if you are identifying that yeast and molds, then the nutrient medium which is used here, it is known as M green YM, that is yeast and molds. Then if you are identifying the total bacteria here, then there is a use of, or we can say TB, or total bacteria. Then there is a use of nutrient medium which is called as triptychase soya. It is known as triptychase soya. Now if there is a use of or identifying fecal streptococci, if there is a identification of these fecal streptococci, then the name of that nutrient medium which is used here, that is KF streptococcal. So this is the nutrient medium, and if there is a identification or the purpose is to identify lactobacillus and resistant bacteria, then there is a use of orange serum is here. But generally, when the purpose is to determine the quality of water, if the purpose is to determine the quality of water, then the nutrient we are going to identify or detect generally that coliforms, because these are the important indicator microorganisms. So these are called as indicator microorganisms. So if our purpose is to determine the quality of water, then we are going to identify or detect these coliforms, whether they are present in that water sample or not. And these coliforms, these are the important indicators of water pollution. So that's why that can be identified. And now the next step is here, that is membrane filtration. Now after selecting the nutrient medium, now the next step includes membrane filtration. So for the filtration of this water through this membrane filtration assembly, that membrane, it is placed over the carbon disc with the help of forceps. Just I already shown in the diagram here. So there is a placing of that membrane filter on this disc, and which is sterilized, that is sterilized with the flame. Then the flame, the opening of the sample bottles, and it is poured on the in that funnel. So water, that water sample is here, it is poured in the funnel, and by using the vacuum pump or that suction pump, that water is water sample is sucked. So we will obtain the filtrate, and whatever that microorganisms are present in that water sample, that microorganisms, they get trapped on the membrane filtrate or on that membrane filter. So these microorganisms, they get trapped on the membrane filter, and then this membrane filter, it is placed on the specific nutrition medium here. So it is placed on the that adsorbent here, which adsorb that nutrient medium, and later on it is transferred to the nutrient membrane or nutrient medium. It is transferred on the nutrient medium, and as I already told earlier here, there is a use of endo agar, or there is a use of eosin methylene blue agar. So these two nutrient mediums are used here. So that can, if there is a presence of that microorganisms on that, or if that microorganisms get trapped on that membrane filter pad or that adsorbent, so that microorganisms or that pad will transfer to this endo agar or EMB agar. So that microorganisms, they will grow, and we are able to detect the presence of that indicator microorganisms, that is coliforms, in that water. So if there is a, suppose for example, if you are using that endo agar for the isolation, then it is actually a selective medium. This medium, it is selective for enteric bacteria. So this endo agar, it is selective for enteric bacteria. It is selective for enteric bacteria, and it is differential for coliforms and non-coliforms. It is differential. This endo agar is differential for coliforms and non-coliforms. So that's why this endo agar, it is a nutrient medium, that is, it is selective as well as differential medium or differential nutrient medium. And because of this component, which is called as basic fuchsin, so this nutrient medium or endo agar, it inhibits the growth of gram positive microorganisms. So it inhibits the growth of gram positive microorganisms. It does not allow the growth of these gram positive microorganisms. So it allows the growth of only gram negative microorganisms. That's why it is selective. Now later on, this nutrient medium, if that water sample consists of coliforms, so these coliforms bacteria, they will produce a special types of colonies here. So these coliforms, if they are present in that water sample, so when we will transfer that membrane filter pad on this nutrient medium, that is on endo agar, and if that water sample consists of coliforms, then these coliforms, they will produce as dark red. They will produce as dark red colonies with metallic sheen. With metallic sheen. So we can identify whether these that water sample consists of coliforms or not. So because they have the dark red colonies with metallic sheen and non-coliform colonies, if they are present in that water sample, non-coliform colonies, if they are present in this water sample here, so these non-coliform colonies present in water sample, so they will appear colorless. So that's why this medium is differential, because it can differentiate between coliforms and non-coliforms. So that's why it is differential, because if coliforms are present in water, they have dark red center colonies or red colonies and with metallic sheen. If non-coliforms are present, then these colonies are without or these are colorless. Okay, so this is about the endo agar. Now if there is a use of eosin methylene blue agar for this membrane filtration assembly, that is EMB or eosin methylene blue agar, then this medium is also selective as well as differential. It is also selective as well as differential nutrient medium. And for coliforms, this that eosin and this methylene blue present in this nutrient medium, it suppresses the growth or it inhibits the growth of gram positive microorganisms. So they will suppress the growth of gram positive microorganisms. And if that water sample consists of E. coli, if there is a presence of E. coli, then the colonies of that E. coli will be small. These are black centered. These are black centered with metallic sheen. So there is a metallic sheen will be present here in that colonies. They have black centered and small colonies will be there. And if there is a presence of enterobacter aerosols, then the colonies will be large. So if there is a presence of enterobacter aerosols, then the colonies will be large. Then these are dark centered. These are dark centered and mucoid without metallic sheen. So here, this is about the procedure of this membrane filtration technique.